Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can quickly duplicate your robot program using a little trick involving reference frame. Let's see how it works. So we pick up where we just left. We have our station with our robot, our part, the path to cut around it, and our tool. For this project, you will need to have a good understanding of how reference frame works. If it's not super clear for you yet, I would highly recommend you to jump on our YouTube channel. In the landing page, you will find RoboDK documentation. And at the end of it, so you can just press a little arrow here, you will find a video called Robot Reference Frames. And I would highly recommend you to watch it. I explain in details how reference frame works for 16 minutes, which is much longer than the time I will spend in this training explaining that specific topic. So I would highly recommend you to take a look at it. Okay, so here, for these tricks to work, you need to properly understand how relative reference or relative positioning works in robotics. So if I create a new frame here, let's call it here, I'm going to move it just on top of Prog 1, so right click, hold, before, and I'm going to name it part 2. So we have part and part 2 as reference frame, and I will bring it right here, let's say. Cool. So if I double click on cutting 6, for example, and I right click here and activate my part 2, and I click on cutting 6 once again, it will move my robot right here. If you take a look, you will see here you have kind of a semi-transparent. I can make it visible. And this one is like the cutting 6 target. You can see that the distance the robot is at right now with respect to the frame part 2, so I can make that invisible and bring the naming back, is the same as the position of target 6 with respect to the frame part. You can do the same with other targets. So as long as you're clicking only once on the target, it will execute this position relative to the reference frame that is currently activated. So in this case, the currently activated reference frame is part 2, as you can see it from the little green dot we have here. If I was to copy a target from here to here, it would kind of keep the same relative position. So that's fine. But that also means that if you were to run one of these instructions without running this one here, or without changing this one for another frame, it would run this instruction with respect to the active frame here. So if I run cutting 13, it will move to that position here relative to the active reference frame, the current active reference frame, which is part 2. So if I run this other one here, this other one here, this other one here, oops, this is my bad, I moved a little something, move back to the right spot here, so 4, 5, it doesn't work with the linear motions for some reasons. I will ask why, but it does work with the linear moves. So the reason why RoboDK automatically add, when you create a new program, a set frame and a set tool is to avoid any confusion like that. It will automatically add a set frame to the parent frame of the first target selected, and the current active tool will also be added. That means that if you go for part 2 here and you right click and start from here, apart from the move C, everything will be run in this second reference frame here. So right click, oops, start from here. Oops. By the way, if you feel like everything is super fast, as I already told you, it's because this is activated here. One of the reasons why this would be activated is that there's a little quirk that we are aware of. But if you're renaming something like that, and if you press space to create a space in the naming, it will toggle that button for some reasons. So that's not a big deal. You just need to be aware of it and just click on it once. So the point is that if part two frame is activated and you right click and start from here, it will run apart from the two move C's that are behaving a bit weirdly, it will run the rest of the program in the second frame. That also means that if you were to change the frame here, so right click here and select part two, the whole program will be generated in this new frame, including the move C's in this case. I told you that if you click once, it would go to the relative position of the target with respect to the currently active frame. If you double click though, it would behave a bit differently. It would activate the first parent frame and would bring the TCP to that specific position. So it will be kind of a real recorded position this way. So that's another difference between the single and double click on a target. Single click will use a move L without any configuration, without respecting configuration, and won't also, it will create a relative motion to the active reference frame. On the other hand, if you double click, it will do a automatic or almost teleportation move J to the position of the target, plus it will activate the parent frame in this case. So that brings us to the last little thing I want to show you. So if I change the name here for cutting, let's say, if I remove set frame, set ref here, part two from this program, what I can do is create a new program called, I don't know, main cutting in this case, so F2 to rename. Right click, add instruction. By the way, you can reach all the instruction you can reach in your toolbar. You can reach by right clicking, add instruction, and select here, and a few more that you can't reach from there. So you'll go program called instruction, and I will go cutting, let's say once, click OK. But what I'll do before is I'll add instruction, and here you have set ref frame instruction. I will select this one here, right click, set reference link. I'm gonna link it with part one first. I'm gonna take this one, right click, drag, hold after. I'm gonna select these twos. So select the first one, hold control, select the second one, control C, and then select the last one, control V. And I will change the frame of this one to part two. So this way, if I run this program one after the other, it will run once in frame part and once in frame part two, as I removed any set frame from this cutting program here. So it's kind of activating the right frame at the beginning and then activating the second right frame at the end. Be aware though that it might have some advert impact when it comes to generating the real program for the real robot, but for simulation purposes, it's a way to save a lot of time and create a duplicate of a given program multiple times in your station without having to recreate all the program and all the targets. So here we didn't even had to copy and paste the content of that. We just switched from one frame to the other to define where that cutting program should start from. Okay, that's pretty much everything for today's video. In the next video, we will talk a bit more about joint targets and joint motions. I've touched on that very quickly when we were doing the inspection process, but I need to cover it more and explain a bit more on that given subject. So hope it was helpful and hope to see you in the next video. Have a great day, guys.